Well, it is a 2019 Minnesota Bear season. We're up here about half a mile from the Canadian border. I'm staying up at Norman Hayes and his brother, and so we appreciate them the opportunity for letting us come up to do that. And we're up here with Christian and Dave and Mandy, and hoping to get Christian a bear. We got two different bait stations up here. Both of them are getting hit pretty good, so we're hoping that we can get Christian out here to get a Minnesota black bear. We also have a couple other sites within 10 to 15 miles from here, so we're getting the action. We just gotta hopefully get one of the bears to cooperate and get Christian a chance at a Minnesota black bear.
Yep. Today. Last night we didn't have much action. We went out early today because we had been getting pictures of a bear out early. So we got out there around like 5:30 and we sat there until like around 7 just when it was starting to get light. And the bear that we had been seeing at 9:30 came out at 7. So it was a little dark because it was cloudy, and we couldn't take the shot because he wouldn't present a good shot. But then we thought we were gonna get a good shot because he was coming straight at us. Like he didn't know we were there. He was just coming straight at us because there was a trail behind our blind, and he walked right under the blind and right down that trail and disappeared. And then we sat there for a couple more hours hoping something would come out, but nothing really ever came out. But we're gonna go back out later and hit the spot where the big bear is and the mom and her cubs are. So hopefully we'll get a lot of action tonight.
Heavenly Father, we just come to you this afternoon, Lord, on this fun but yet challenging bear hunt, Lord, and we just thank you for each day that we have. Thank you for all that you've done on the cross for us, Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we just ask your hands of favor on Christian this afternoon, Lord. We pray that it would be your will for him to harvest a bear today, Lord, or at least before the end of this trip. And so, Lord, we just put this in your hands, and we trust in you and your will. And we ask again that you would you'd bless us tonight, Lord Jesus. Keep us safe, keep us healthy, and protect us during this hunt, Lord Jesus. And bless Christian with a nice bear this afternoon, Lord. And we just, again, thank you for who you are and what you mean and what you've done. And we pray this in your name, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. All right, let's go get him, big guy.
hit him. You hit him.
Yeah, there's blood everywhere.
Okay, listen. Listen for the death call.
I think he's laying right there.
Did you get a good shot right behind your front shoulder?
Did you have a lot of adrenaline when you took the shot?
Yeah. Well, it took forever. He started over there, walked across the field, stopped over there. I was like, oh, I was like, please stop over here. But he didn't. So he went in there and like he started moving the bait, this log, and to get into the bait. And he kept going down and standing back
you
up
had to wait
and going
and wait.
Down. Yeah. I had to wait because there's a little thing that was in the way.
Yeah, baby. That's a dead bear.
That's awesome, buddy.
That's super awesome. Good job.
Is that a good shot?
Mm-hmm. It's a male.
It's a male. You got yourself a boar, buddy.
All right.
Well, finally got one. Took 2 years, but we got one. He came in across the field, like, unexpectedly. Didn't hear any squawking from the blue jays or anything. And he came across the field, and I thought I was going to have a shot, and he was going to stop right in front of the bait out in this field over here. But he didn't, and so he went in, started eating, and he was up. Down, up, down. So I had to take a lot of breaks while trying to aim at him, but it only took a couple seconds for him to take the right step and he was down. He didn't run that far, not even 20 yards. And he does have a white blaze on here. We had been seeing him in some of the camera cards. And just thank the landowners, Phil and Norm Hayes. Thank Justin Crosley and Jim Boyer for helping sponsor me for this, even though it was 2 years ago. Still, thank you guys. I'd like to thank Tom and Darvis for taking time out of their lives and to come and help me get this bear and help bait it in. And he's nice and soft.
And I think that the whole time. That we sat out there and didn't see anything. It was just God saying that the bears that we were seeing on the camera weren't meant for me, and that the bear that I got was the one that God had picked for me and the one that He had in my plan. And I just, sometimes you have struggles, and waiting in the blind was a struggle for me because it was boring, and I would just sit there, I'm like, oh, I'm so bored. And then I would start just thinking about stuff in my mind or being like, I can smell the bear cooking on the grill already. but sometimes you have a lot of struggles, and sometimes it's hard to do what you want to do, and sometimes it gets harder for you to do the stuff that you used to be able to do, but no matter what, I always try to continue to do what I used to do. If I have to, like, I had to get a stair lift on my stairs so I could go up and down, but it doesn't limit me from going up and down the stairs. It helps me a lot, and so I'm not tired. But I try to make the most out of my life and the most out of hunting. I've got quite a few trophies that came from a lot of time in the woods and a long time before I even got to shoot at a deer. It took me like 3 or 4 years of sitting in the blind day in, day out, nothing. I think the thing that keeps me going is just the ability to come out into the beautiful stuff like this and just do what I love to do. That's how I get through my struggles. I just know that good things are going to come and that it's not going to be that hard. It's just a little period of time. Like whenever I got my driver's license, I failed the first time, and I was told that it's just a small period of time, and now it seems like nothing. So like whatever you're going through and whatever's happening, it's just a period of time, and it'll pass. So just got to have the right outlook on life and just have fun with it. Do what you want to do. Dream big.